We are joined in the media center here at the Vegas Four-Wide NHRA Nationals by our Lucas Oil Top Alcohol Dragster winning driver and team owner for Camping World Series Funny Car, Tony Stewart. Tony, you broke through. You got your first double up as a driver, as an owner. We're going to talk a little bit about what you did behind the wheel today. But first off, the significance of this moment. You've already given the details that you've won on every racetrack on the property here at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. So tell us about today's win and where does it fall in with all those others?
Well, I know it's not a Pro Series win, but to win in this class, I mean, I haven't seen the time slip, but they said all four cars were within 200ths on ET. So the field's been tight all weekend, and it was when we raced here last fall. And I was just ecstatic to make the finals last fall. So, you know, even today, I told Leah, you know, we had a little bit of time before we had to get suited up for finals. And I said, I'm not just happy to be in the finals today. I said, I want this. So, and real racers, you always want to win. I mean, nobody likes losing, but, you know, I think it was the perfect scenario last year. I think Madison winning her first race was probably the best storyline you could have, having a rookie driver in his first race, and Madison Payne had never been to a Nationals final, to win her first National and to just have the opportunity to race with her was an amazing deal for us. And the beginning of the season has been super difficult with this new car. You know, I'm used to new cars and sprint cars and cup cars, and you get excited about a new car because they're normally always better. And we've really struggled with this new car, unfortunately. It's I think we found some things. We went to Bakersfield after Pomona. Richie drove the car because this car was actually originally being built for Richie to drive it. And so I told Richie, I said, you need to drive us at the test. I said, you need to drive your own race car. And honestly, we didn't learn anything at the test. It was a disaster. And we're sitting there talking to each other, just going, what about this? And even asking stupid things to check, just because we're like, we're not finding what it's wanting and what we're missing here. There's got to be something, though, that we're just overlooking. So nobody's feeling got hurt. We're all checking each other going, what about this? What about this? What about this? And they found a couple of things that were wrong. They made a couple changes that were different from that picked the car up as well, and really just went through this car with this off week with a fine tooth comb to get it better. And I knew as soon as I did the burnout on Friday that this was a better car. Knew how fast the motor spooled up, that we were in a better spot. So it was a hard day Friday because it shook both sessions. And I told him at the end of the day, he was scratching his head, and I said, hey, I said, I'm super ecstatic right now. I said, we can get there from here. It's a lot easier to pull the reins back and slow them down than it is to be like a racehorse and try to pull the whip out and get it to go faster. So at least we found the speed in it. It was just a matter of getting it balanced. And we really need more runs on this thing to really get it dialed in. But, you know, yesterday Q3 was an important run for us because we weren't in the show yet. And run four, we had a problem. And that run was the only data we've got with this new configuration. So it shows why Rich McPhillips has been as successful in this class as he's been. He can sit there and pick apart the sections of the racetrack that we need to be better at, the sections that we needed to guard against, like we found on Friday, and how to really work the package for race day today.
All right, we're going to open it up to members of the media, starting out with Phil Burgess from NHRA National Dragster. If you have a question, please let me know, for our top alcohol dragster winner, Tony Stewart. Phil?
Tony, it's just your fourth national event, fifth overall, but your first four-wide. How did you handle the four-wide staging and racing?
I thoroughly enjoyed it. I'll be honest, to me, it feels like it kind of brings that short track feel. It's like every time we went up there the first two rounds, it felt like heat races. It's like you don't have to win, you just got to transfer. So, you know, and luckily we won our quad both rounds, but it just gave that Saturday night short track feel to me. And honestly, if you just pay attention to what you're doing and you know when you pull in your lane what lane you're in, you know what bulb to look at. We put a little piece of tape on the dash and just put the number just in case for some reason I forgot. I could look at that as a reference, but I like the four-wide format. I mean, I think it's exciting for everybody, but there's a lot of extra people and a lot of extra stuff going on the starting line, but you know, yesterday our qualifying run, we had somebody that broke, and the official told me somebody broke in that lane, so you know not to watch for that bulb. So I think the officials do a great job of, you know, making sure it runs really smooth, and I like it. It's hard not like it when you win at it, but I think it's a cool deal. I mean, for me personally, being able to run all three of our rounds with the pros and with Matt and these guys today, I mean, that makes you feel good. I mean, you know you're in a sportsman class, but those guys down there that I'm in the pits with, I mean, it's so many of those people have come up and said, thanks for being a part of it. Thanks for giving our class attention. And, you know, I'm proud to be an alcohol driver right now. I like what I'm doing.
Tony, can you take a second to recap all the wins that you've had on this property? You rattled off a couple of things. We mentioned the Cup Series win over on the round track, but you had like three or four or more. Tell us all the different victories and different styles of racing that have happened right here at Vegas.
The Bullring is their short track, and pavement short track, and we won in a USAC midget and USAC sprint car on the same night. The dirt track, we've won in a ASCS 360 wing sprint car, and I won my first USAC Silver Crown race here at the dirt track, and then the Cup car at the big track, and here today. So pretty cool deal. Plus, we in 97, we won our own IndyCar championship, finished here at Vegas, and that's when we locked up the championship, was here as well.
Amazing. Susan Wade, your question.
Two quick questions. Do you think that the reason you adapted so quickly to the 4-wide is because you're used to having cars on different sides of you, and you have maybe developed a good peripheral vision?
Yeah, and honestly, I looked forward to this event when we were doing the schedule, and when I found out we had the opportunity to run 4-wide as well, I got excited about it, because there's no way I'm not going to sit there and say I'm not at a disadvantage, you know, when you're going up against guys that have been drag racing for years, but they don't race 4-wide a lot, so that kind of gets them out of their comfort zone and gets them out doing something different, and it's all different for me. So I felt like if anything, this would be a little bit of an equalizer, and not I wouldn't be at quite the disadvantage. So you know, I embraced it. I can't wait to go to Charlotte and do it again.
You're one of the few who probably says that. But are your friends in other places, or your colleagues in other places, getting kind of irritated that you're talking so much about drag racing all the time?
I don't give a shit. I don't care if NASCAR's mad. I don't care if anybody's mad. I'm having fun living my life now. I'm able to control my life. I don't have to do all the things that I had to do in my previous jobs. And I have more control of my life again. I got great teammates that drive for us. A great wife, and Matt's been, those two have been the best teachers you could ask for and get advice from. So, they all know I'm having fun. I think it's the opposite of what you thought. In all honesty, everybody, the comment I get the most is how happy I look. Everybody goes, you just look so happy. You look happy, you look at peace, and I haven't had that for a long time. So I'm in a very good spot in my life right now.
All right, we got one more for Tony Stewart. Crystal Clay, your question for Tony.
Yes, on Thursday, Leah said that when it comes to drag racing, it's the only time you listen to her. So now that you're hearing that, what do you have to say?
She might have exaggerated a little bit. So it's normally whoever's voice starts changing octaves first is who listens to who at that point. But no, I mean, we have a great dynamic. I think what makes our relationship work so well, there's a ton of things that we're exactly the same on, and then there's things that we're the polar opposite on. And it's the things that drive us crazy with each other, but at the same time, it creates the balance in our life, and I feel like it works well for us because of that.
All right, you've got a 4-wide win, but you still need a 2-wide win, right, to complete the transition to drag racer. We figure it's coming, but just look ahead to that accomplishment. This is a nice step along the way.
Yeah, it is. It's nice this early in the season to get this car going finally. And like I said, I'm happier for my team than anything. I mean, the amount of work and effort they put into all three cars, Jasmine's cars, when Matt Cummins drives the car, when Mike drives the car, the amount of effort with the amount of guys that we have on that team to do what we do, they don't overlook any details. I mean, it's been extremely frustrating, like I said, at the beginning of the year, but I'm very, very happy and proud at this moment for those guys of how hard they've worked and seeing the results.
Tony, congratulations on your win. Thank you.
Thanks, sir. Appreciate it.